Hi everybody, this is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you happy? I hope so. Today we are going to look at words and phrases connected with a bodily action that literally keeps us alive. In fact, you are doing it right now as I'm talking. In this lesson, we are all going to take in some information about breathing. The word breathe names the action of taking air into the body. We all need to breathe. The action of breathing keeps us alive. Most animals breathe. They take in air, which contains oxygen. It is this that the body needs in order to survive. Oxygen is a non-metallic element. You could describe an element as a building block. A chemical element is made of a single atom. Your body is made up of different types of atoms, and oxygen is one of them. In fact, 2/3 of your body mass is made up of oxygen. In our atmosphere, oxygen exists as a gas. This gas consists of oxygen atoms that have coupled or joined together. The gas is colourless and odourless. Oxygen is in the air we breathe. When pressurised, oxygen can also exist as a liquid. In total, oxygen in the air we breathe makes up around 21% of the Earth's atmosphere. The element itself was discovered in the late 18th century by Joseph Priestley, an English clergyman who was able to isolate the gas and, in doing so, discovered the link between it and many living creatures. His experiments involved lit candles and mice. He found that the candles burned brighter in the gas and that a mouse was more active and lived longer when that particular gas was present. Although Joseph Priestley is credited with reporting his discovery first, the person who actually discovered oxygen was the Swedish chemist Carl Wilhelm Scheele, also in the late 18th century. The chemical symbol for oxygen is O, and the symbol for the oxygen we breathe is O2. O2 is known as dioxygen. Without oxygen, we would not be here. In fact, most life on Earth would not exist were it not for the presence of oxygen. Oxygen is in the air we breathe and the water we drink. It is present in our bodies and even in the Earth itself. This is why the presence of oxygen on other planets is such an important thing. The aim of scientists who are studying the universe is to discover other planets with water, which contains oxygen. The notion being, where there is oxygen, there could be life. All life revolves around oxygen. In one way or another. We breathe it in for survival. Plants and trees produce it. In fact, it is the reverse of what we do. Put simply, when you breathe in, you take in oxygen. When you breathe out, you expel carbon dioxide. Plants and trees use carbon dioxide and produce oxygen through a process called photosynthesis. Sunlight provides plants and trees with the means to store energy converted from carbon dioxide and expel it as oxygen. This is why the Earth's rainforests are so important. In fact, the rainforests of South America and Asia are often referred to as being the lungs of the Earth. Although this is not entirely accurate, as the rainforest's importance comes from the turnover or use and production of oxygen, rather than the production itself. Concentrated oxygen promotes fast combustion. This means that it helps something to burn. It creates fire easily. It can be unstable in certain situations, such as when it is stored near other types of fuel. A fire uses oxygen to burn. The surrounding air feeds a fire, as does the thing that is burning. In both cases, it is the oxygen that fuels the fire. Liquid oxygen is used in rocket fuel as an oxidizer. Liquid oxygen is another form of the element. In its purest form, liquid oxygen has a cryogenic nature. This means that it is incredibly cold. It will freeze anything it comes into contact with. Cryogenics is an area of science that deals with cold temperatures. If you ever see a person in hospital with a breathing mask on, then they are taking in oxygen. Oxygen therapy allows a patient to take in oxygen more efficiently. If a person has weak lungs or some other medical condition, then oxygen therapy can help them feel better. Although, in some cases, it will not cure the problem. The action of breathing involves taking in air through the nose or mouth. The air goes down a pipe called the trachea or windpipe. This then divides into two smaller pipes called bronchial tubes. These tubes continue into the lungs, where they divide into much smaller tubes called bronchioles. You have two lungs in your body. However, each lung is made up of sections called lobes. The purpose of the lungs is to filter oxygen into the blood. This is not to be confused with air. It is only the oxygen itself that enters the bloodstream. Air must never get into the bloodstream, as this would prove fatal. The internal structure of each lung looks like a tree. Millions of tiny interlocked sacs called alveoli act as gas exchangers. This is where the breathed in oxygen enters the blood, and the carbon dioxide is taken away and expelled as you breathe out. The lungs supply oxygen to the right side of the heart, which in turn pumps the blood around the body. The waste is pumped from the left side of the heart and is transferred into the lungs, where it becomes carbon dioxide. Needless to say, your lungs are very important organs. It is possible to live with only one lung, but absolutely impossible to live without both. This is why it is so important to look after them, as once they have been damaged, there is nothing you can do to fix them. Because of their nature, the lungs are very vulnerable and susceptible to damage and disease. The most common diseases affecting the lungs are asthma, bronchitis, and pneumonia. Asthma is an illness that causes the airways of the lungs to swell. This particular condition can be caused by many things. Anxiety and stress can cause an asthma attack in those who are affected. It is thought that asthma can be genetic. It can be passed on through the genes. For many years, I myself suffered from asthma. Fortunately, it has now cleared and I'm no longer affected by it. Bronchitis is the swelling or inflammation of the tubes leading into the lungs. cigarette smoking or breathing in toxic fumes or pollution can cause bronchitis. Pneumonia is the inflammation of the alveoli sacs. This is normally caused by an infection. Despite the development of antibiotics, pneumonia remains one of the largest causes of death among the very young and very old in developing countries. Most lung diseases have similar symptoms. Coughing. Wheezing. Loss of breath. Shortness of breath and the production of mucus are all signs of a lung disorder. Another problem that can occur is a collapsed lung. This is when air enters the area that seals the lungs in. The air causes the lungs to shrink or collapse. This is called a pneumothorax. During my teenage years, I suffered two collapsed lungs at different times, both of which put me in hospital. I don't seem to have much luck with my lungs. Fortunately for me, I have never smoked and I take regular exercise. So now my lungs are strong and healthy again. When you breathe in, you inhale. You are inhaling. The action is called inhalation. When you breathe out, you exhale. You are exhaling. This action is called exhalation. You can take a deep breath. You can take a shallow or short breath. The normal rate of breathing usually falls between deep and shallow. Then there is yawning, which is a kind of breathing and stretching reflex. You often yawn when you are tired, but yawning can also occur through visual stimulation. If you see a person yawn, then there is a good chance that you will yawn too. Even thinking about yawning can cause you to yawn for real. Did you yawn too? The action of breathing is called respiration. This is the term used in medicine to describe the process of taking in air and the exchange of oxygen for carbon dioxide. All animals breathe, however, the structure of the organs used and the means of obtaining the oxygen vary between species. For example, the lungs of a bird are different to those of a human. Fish breathe through openings called gills. They extract the oxygen from the water. There is nothing like taking in a breath of fresh air. The exhilarating feeling you get from taking a deep breath of outdoor air can be really therapeutic. The word therapeutic means that something is beneficial. It can be good for you. It can even help you recover from an illness. If you take in deep breaths, then you stimulate the body. It is believed that deep breathing is good for clearing out the impurities in your body. There are many ways in which deep breathing can help you. If you ever feel stressed or anxious, then taking deep breaths can really help. Deep, steady breathing causes the body to release chemicals called endorphins into the system. These endorphins are a natural relaxant. Deep breathing techniques can help to relieve pain, lower blood pressure, and relieve the symptoms or signs of anxiety. It is possible to stop breathing for a short time. You hold your breath. You control your breathing consciously. You take in a breath and then stop. A person normally holds their breath when they go underwater, as breathing underwater will kill you. You will drown. Humans cannot breathe underwater. Unlike fish, we do not have gills. If a person stops breathing without intending to, then they only have a short time to start breathing again before any damage is caused. The body needs oxygen. The brain needs it to function. Certain illnesses can cause a low oxygen level in the body. This is called hypoxia. Of course, too much oxygen and not enough carbon dioxide can also be bad for you. If you take in deep breaths for a long period of time, you will start to feel dizzy and lightheaded. You are taking in too much oxygen and not enough carbon dioxide is being produced. You are hyperventilating. This is called hyperventilation. After taking exercise, you might find that you cannot catch your breath. You are out of breath. Your body cannot get enough air into the lungs. You are breathless. You cannot catch your breath. Becoming breathless after strenuous exercise is normal. But if you feel breathless after standing up or walking up the stairs, then this is a sign of poor health. A person who gets out of breath easily might be unfit or unwell. There are some phrases and idioms in English that relate to breathing. To hold your breath can be used as an idiom for anticipation. You are waiting for something to happen. You are anticipating something. This can be used negatively or positively. We can also say, don't hold your breath. This expresses doubt about something. You tell a person not to expect anything. He said he will marry you? Well, don't hold your breath. You can be left breathless by something amazing. A big surprise can leave you breathless. The words breathe and breath are often confused. The word breathe is the action of breathing, and breath is what is produced by breathing. When you breathe, you produce breath. You breathe in and out. Breath goes in and out of you. If you breathe in suddenly, then we can describe this as a gasp. You gasp with surprise or shock. If you are drowning in water, you will gasp for air. If you are out of breath, then you will be gasping. To let out breath slowly is to sigh. You sigh because you feel sad or disappointed. A sigh can also be used to show relief or satisfaction. If a person tries to stop you from breathing by placing something over your nose and mouth, then they are suffocating you. They are trying to suffocate you. The action is called suffocation. The person doing the suffocating is trying to kill you. You can suffocate underground or in a box that has no air inside it. Other words for suffocate include asphyxiate, choke, stifle, and smother. Suffocate can also be used as an idiom to describe the feeling of being trapped in a relationship with someone who is too demanding and possessive. Oh, this relationship is suffocating. You are suffocating me. I really love to breathe, and do you know why? Because if I didn't, I would surely die. Breathing in and out all day through helps to keep me conscious and aware of you. The air in my lungs feeds my brain, which might sound strange, but it happens through a process of gas exchange. So the next time you breathe in, which will happen soon, I'm sure, that air you've taken in will stop you falling to the floor. Well, this has been a very busy lesson, don't you think? I'm almost out of breath. I need to catch my breath. I need to take a rest and get my breath back. I hope you have enjoyed today's lesson, and I look forward to seeing you all again really soon. This is Mr. Duncan in England, taking a deep breath and saying thank you for watching me teaching you, and of course, ta-ta for now. This pillow will come in very useful. Oh, God.